a day, which is the accuracy, and error. No, so just like I've said, no, there are times na dili man kinahanglan jud nga accurate, kinahanglan jud na isolve pa nimo to FM to meter. That's why we need to discuss about accuracy and errors, no, kay para kay kaning accuracy ug errors kani sila may mga delimiters, kung one of the delimiters kung kano sa lang tataman mag-compute, no, using numerical solutions. Okay, so i-share sa nako ni Miss Light. Okay, so maklaro na bang screen? Thumbs up sabi kung maklaro. Okay, sige. So, okay. Kana siya, no? So, dire sa tama discuss sa accuracy sa numbers. So, there are two kinds of numbers, no? We have the exact, just like I've said earlier, na naay mga exact na number, which is mo na siyang ginasolve, no? Nga, termi, kung sa kuan pa na siya, mathematics, no? Kung kinsay mga math, kuan dire, math wizard dire, mo ni silang ma-determinate, no, kanang finite numbers, kanang determinate of finite numbers, no, so which is exact na siya. For example, kaning 8, no, exact siya 8, no, wala siya 8 point something na unending, no. And then example po dyan is 9.75. So 9.75 radyo siya taman. Then we have the 1/2, which is equal to 0.5. And then we have the 1/4, which is equal to 0.25. We have the 3/4, which is equal to 0.75. No, so kana siya exacto dyan siya na dira radyo siya taman. And then we also have these approximate numbers, no, just like the pi. So pag mental approximate is unending na siya. No, dili lang siya dihara na siya taman, kinahanglan pa na siya i-compute antud pino, no, sa pina up to million hundreds, no, pila ka book na siya ka decimal points or decimal places na, no. So although dayuban nga unending jud siya, no, so that's why we're just making approximation out of that number, just like the pi, no. So 3.14 actually sa uban gani kay 16 na lang daman, no, 3.1416, no, so up to 4 decimal places lang. So is square root of 2, 1.414 kasagari ginagamit, di ba? So up to 3 decimal places lang kani put si 1/3, no. So although repeating jud siya, 0.333 anto sa infinity na siya, assume na lang nato na siya panagsa na 0.33, no? So in this case, these are just the unapproximate numbers, no? So kana siya ang two kinds of numbers. Okay, so in this case, what can you say regarding sa accurate? Kung halimbawa may kag-exact o approximate, ha, kinsa ka between the two ani ang mas ang much accurate? Yes, of course, no, the exact, because it is terminus, no, mo mundang siya, no. So probably ang enda na zero na, so the error will be probably zero, no. So which is i-discuss po nato kung saan na siya ang error. Okay, so which is approximate is na pa siya equal sumpay, so probably mo siya either round down ni mo, round off, no. So pag round down o round up ni mo, bisag unsaon jud na siya ni mo, i-compare ni mo na siya sa actual jud na value na niya, na jud siya error, no. Kaya nag-approximate ra man ka, for example 0.333, tama man ka sa tulo ka decimal places, so probably na pa kay error nga negative 0.000333 at to infinity, no. So probably ang mas accurate is ang exact numbers, no. Kaya siya, so that's the accuracy of the numbers. So one of the indicators accuracy of the number is the error, no. So in numerical solutions we have 7 types of error. We have the inherent errors, we have the roundoff errors, we have the truncation errors, we have the absolute errors, we have relative errors, we have percentage errors, and we also have the general formula for error. No? So, unsa ni siyang inherent errors? So, si inherent errors exist in the problem either due to approximate given data, limitations of computing aids. This can be minimized by taking better data and using high precision computing aids. So, si inherent errors is nakabase na siya sa kung sa itong gigamit pag-solve. No, either ang method na to sa pag-solve or kung sa itong instrument na gigamit pag-solve. No? So, as you, kung kisa may, I think kasagari man sa inyo is STEM, no? Nakakandak pa mo mga kanang laboratory activity sa chemistry. So, bisag sa metro lang mismo, kanang metro, kanang kita man mo metro sana, di ba? So, di ba, na yung mga measure sa, ang metro san, siya may instrument, no? Limited siya, na kuan dyan niya, makita ninyo na limited lang siya up to millimeters, no? So, it means na, kung halimbawa, measure ta og mga values sub millimeter, bali, 0.01 sa millimeter, dili na nato na siya ma-measure, no? So, probably, na siya error up to yung anak, no? Tungod kay ang atong instrument is limited lang man siya into millimeter itself, no? So, bali, probably, sub millimeter, di na siya na siya existing error ana, no? Which is mo na siyang inherent errors, no? So, with regards to computation method po, no? Just like what we will discuss later on, we will be doing more on approximation, no? So, sa approximation na sa atong methods na gamito, na siya yung mga corresponding inherent errors, no? So, kana siya. And then, ma-minimize lang na siya using the, instead of methods, data de siya, no? So, for example, ang yung data is limited siya into, up to centimeter lang, no? So, probably, ang sa millimeter na kuan na part, na siya error in terms of millimeter, probably, kung ano mo, ang measurement niya is 1.25. So, unya ang real measurement niya is 1.253, no? So probably na siya error nga 0.03, no? Probably 3 millimeter, no? Tungod kay ang imong data is na limit man siya or na approximate man siya up to centimeter raman, no? Which is 1.25. So probably sa probably na dyan siya error na 3 milli, no? Because that's the true measurement niya, no? So, para ma-minimize na siya, kinanglan lang nato mo take og better data na higher accuracy, no? Up to millimeter ba, up to decimal of millimeter, no? Up to tens of millimeter, hundreds ba sa millimeter, no? Ang kaya niyang kuha o na data, so much better. And we may also use high precision data in computing, just like kung mag-measure mo o length using laser, no? Na natin yung mga laser instrument para mag-measure length. So, kana siya ang inherent error. So, take note na to na inherent errors is came from the data itself and the computing aids, no? Or the instrument na itong gigamit. Okay, so we also have the roundoff errors, no? So, during computation na niya. So, kasagari dyan, pag mag-compute ta, di ba, ga-roundoff man dyan siya. So, just like I explained earlier regarding the exact and the approximate. So, pag mag-round off ta, na siya corresponding din yung error, no? So, just like this, no? We have the 7.5846712, no? And then, ga-round off siya into 7.585. So, probably, tungkol kay ga-round off siya nimo sa 7.585, kung i-minus nimo ang original niya na value, which is 7.5846712, na siya error, which is negative 0.003288. And this error is called the Randolph error. Okay, so kana siya ang round of error. So is the error na ma-produce nimo pag mag-round off ka. Okay? Yan na siya. So later on ato lang maka-encounter man pud ta sa atong mga problems ana. Okay, so we also have the truncation error. So this error arises due to the use of approximate formula in computation or by truncating the infinite series to some approximate terms. The study of this type of error is usually associated with the problem of convergence or infinite series. So kaning truncation errors kay, for example, natay mga general formula no, which is mathematically exact yun na siya na formula, but physically or even mathematically dili siya solvable, no? That's why we do truncation, no? I-chunk nato ang dako na formula into infinite series, which is ang example ana niya isang Taylor approximation or series, no? So Taylor series, that's an example of truncation sa isa ka formula. So ang error na makuha nimo out from that is the truncation error, no? Sa pag-chunk nimo sa isa ka bulky na formula or function, no, gi-chunk nimo siya into different into an infinite series. So sa pag-chunk nimo ana na kay ma-produce ana na error. So that's the truncation error. Okay, so sa truncation error na include ana ang convergence, no? So which is later on sa Taylor series ato po na siya i-discuss further kung saan na siya ang convergence. Okay, so kana siya. So example na naman mani siya na sa Taylor series. So which is an infinite series. So have you gone into engineering data analysis? Sometimes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I suppose na nakaagi naman mo Taylor series, 'di ba? Na na-cover ba ninyo?
Sa mga sir, kay wala pa sir.
Ah, wala ninyo na-cover.
Wala.
Okay, okay, sige. Sige, so okay, so ako na lang na siya i-discuss o much deeper, no? So, kana siya, no? Later on, apart man po siya sa itong subtopic, no? So, kana siya si Taylor series. So, sa karon isa ko lang siya sa ipahapya, no? Para madiscuss na ito kung saan siya si truncation error. Okay, so, si Taylor series, for example, na kay function, no? Na y of x, no? Which is, mana siya si y of x. So, kani si y of x is gi-chunk siya or gi-truncate siya into Taylor series, which is equal siya sa y sub o plus x y x times y prime sub o plus x squared over 2 factorial y sub y prime sub o plus x cubed y triple prime sub o over 3 factorial and so on and so forth up to x to the power of n y to the nth differential sub o over n factorial, no, and then so on so forth pa dyan na siya. Kaya infinite series man siya, no? So bali si ang isa ka function gi-breakdown siya into this series, no? Kaya much easier man siya isolve kumpara sa kung halimbawa imo siya iman kanang i-compute siya manumano. So for example, mga special function just like sine, no, nabatay mga means, no, to solve for sine manually or kanang tawagan na conventionally nabatay method, di ba? Wala based atong mga gipang this mga previous natin ng mga classes, di ba? Wala tay kuan na lang, wala tay method nga na ibalaan. Basta kasayad lang ta na ang sine is ang sine day is equal to 1/2. Ang sine day sa 45 is equal to square root of 2 over 2. And then ang sine day sa 60, cosine day sa 60 is 1/2. No? Because we are already told 2. But computing for the kantong, for example, may special numbers na just like cosine sa 1. No? So, sa unyo, pag-solve ang cosine sa 1. So, wala tagitudloan na in the kuha na to. in the previous natin ng mga courses or klase, no? So, para ma-solve na siya, ginagamitan na siya mga Taylor's, mga series, just like this Taylor series, which is a truncation, no? A method of truncation. So, sa pag-truncate, ananana siya corresponding ananana error. So, just like sa, for example, ang imong truncation is dire lang taman sa second degree, no, which is x squared y double prime, no, sub o over 2 factorial. So, kaning x cube y triple prime sub o over 3 factorial, so on, wala na siya. Bale, determinate na imong imong approximation, taman lang aning second degree. So, probably, taman lang na siya sa 0.01 squared. No, just like, for example, ang imong giassume na x or giassume na yung na value is 0.1. No? So, and then taman na siya sa squared. So, which is equal siya sa 0.01. So, probably, ang imong value is maroundo food siya into 0.01 na food. No? So, which is in fact, kining x cube y double y triple prime is na papud siya corresponding value, no? So which is, since gi terminate na nimong series, taman lang diri, ah. So ang mga values ani nila sa uban pud mawala na siya. So which is mo na siyang error, no? Which is mo na siyang mahimong error katong pag terminate nimo sa series. Okay, kana siya, no? So just like this, no? So let y is equal to 1 plus x over 2. So balik kaning y na to is gitrankate siya into yung ani na series. So we have 1 plus x over 2 plus x squared over 2 plus 3x cube over 8 plus so on so forth. So giterminate na siya, taman lang diriya sa third degree, no? So the rest ng mga value dito is wala na, no? So kana siya, no? So and then we have y, i-assume na itong atong x to be 0.1. So we have 1 plus 0.1 over 2 plus 0.1 squared over 2 plus 3 times 0.1 cube over 8. And then kung ato na siya i-simplify, may mo na siya 1.055375. So although kung ato na siya yung i-round off, mag-result siya into 1.0554. But that is not the truncation error. Ang atong truncation error is ang iyang third, ang iyang fourth baling nga degree. And up to infinity pa, no? So, let me show you, mag-show lang ko calculator. Okay, para at inyong masabtan. Okay, dugay kayo ang calculator. Sige lang, so basta kana siya, for example, ang next ani na series is probably ang next ani na series is 1 1 2 0 1 3. So probably 4 siguro ni siya, no? 4 over 24 ata ni, 4 over 24, 4x to the power of 4 over 24, no? So kung unsay, kung i-substitute na mo ang value ni x dito sa 4x to the 4th over 24, probably mao na po siya ang mahimong truncation error, kay determinate naman ni mo siya taman lang sa x cube, no? So bali ang the rest na niabot siya sa x to the 4th, x to the 5th, f to the 6th, and so on so forth, wala na ni mo siya na consider. So which is mo na siyang ma-consider na error. Okay? Sige, so nag-gets ra ba? Any question? Kaya di sa akong move on kung wala na sabtan kay murag. Wala question? Or wala d'yo yung nag-gets? Sige, eh, mag-ask ko, no? So, I will consider this a, kung ano, a... I consider this a an oral, no? Sa kung kinsa yung makatubag, no? This will be a 5 points oral, no? Kinsa yung makatubag. So, if I terminate my infinite series up to 4th degree, in what degree will I start to have a truncation error? So, hello, kinsa to? Villegas, sige, yung same answer.
Sa 5th degree, sir.
Sa 5th degree, up to? Okay, so mo na siyang truncation error, no? So, thank you Villegas na para ma-confirm na ako dahil niya nakasabot, nasabta na ninyo, no? So, mo na siyang truncation error. Okay, so from the fifth in, from the fifth degree up to the infinity, so ma-consider na siya na error, no? Okay, wala na niyong, determinate niyo siya taman sa 4, so the rest na error na siya. Okay? Sige. So, let's move on to absolute error and relative error. So, we have this absolute error and relative error. So, kano sa muna tumayangon niya ang error is absolute. So, if x is true value quantity and x prime is its approximate value, just like what we have shown ganina, no, na natay true value, and then we also have the approximate. So, ang absolute value ana niya, absolute error ana, which is the EA, equal siya sa absolute value sa x minus x prime, no? So, which is mo na siyang approximate value. So, kung i-subtract ni mo na silang dua ka value, ang true, ang approximate, makuha ni mo ang absolute error. And then, we also have the relative error, no? So, si relative error equal siya sa same gapon absolute error, but imo siyang i-divide than sa absolute value sa true value, no? Absolute error siya divided by the absolute error siya divided by the absolute value of the true value, no? So mana siyang relative error. So nganong gi-differentiate pa man jud ning absolute error of relative error? Nganong sa manday pulusa na nganong kinanglan man sa tanawon, no? So kana siyang si absolute error, kinanglan na siya nimo tanan og relative error, kinanglan nimo siya ibulag tungod kay there are some quantities na kinanglan niya na value is ang absolute error, no? Distance, no? So we need absolute error sa distance when you are measuring, for example, na kay material, no? Let's say wood. Then kinanglan mo siya ibutang sa isa ka table, no? Let's say table, simple yun lang na table. Unya, siya na lang missing piece bali, no? And then the rest, bali na siya tulo ka legs, no? Nanalay isa ka leg na nabilin, no? So, and then, ang nabilin na naki material na wood, which is approximately na siya sa 2 feet, no? Let's say 2 feet lang, mabuungan siya na table lang, no? Na 2 feet. Kunya, ang imong material is 2 feet, pero ang imong dari sa mga legs sa table is 2 feet and 1 inch, no? So it means na ang imong material is gahol siya or kulang siya og 1 inch, no? So kana siya ang atong consideration na is 1 inch ang atong error, so kulang ta og 1 inch para makuha na to, mabalance na to atong lamesa, no? So sa inga na case, ang atong kinanglan nga error is ang absolute, because ang kinanglan na to idugang atong katas-on sa atong material or wood material na to is absolute value, no? Dili siya relative, No? So, kana siya. So, how about ang relative? Kano saan siya magamit? Ang relative, magamit ni siya kung halimbawa mag-compare ka og duha ka value. No? So, for example, mag-compare ka og instrument A na pagka instrument B. Since instrument A, ang iyang gi-measure is 100 meters. Si instrument B, ang iyang gi-measure is 10 meters lang. No? So, gusto ni may compare kung kinsay mas accurate aning duha sa duha ka instrumento na ang na-measure aning A kay 100, ang measure aning B kay 10 lang, no? So, ang error ni A, instrument A is 0.5 meters, no? Or roughly 50 centimeter, no? And then si kuan si instrument B, ang iyang error is 0.25, no? So kung atong gamitan ang absolute error, no, para mas ma-compare ang duha ka instrumento, makaingon ta na mas accurate si instrument B because mas gamay man siya ang error, no? 0.25. But in compare to instrument A, which is 0.5 siya, no? So absolute, kung natin consider ang absolute error, mas accurate si instrument B. But ang ilang gi-measure ni instrument A is 100. Si instrument B is 10. So kung ato tanawon in terms of weight sa gi-measure, mas dako og weight ang gi-measure ni instrument A, no? So instead of using the absolute error to compare the kuan the accuracy of two instrument, atong gamiton isang relative error, no? Kay para ma-distribute na to, ma-compare na to, ma-consider na to kung unsa pud katako ang ilang gi-measure, no? So for example, instrument A, no, is 100. So i-divide nat 100, unyang iyang error is 0.5, no? So 0.5 divided by 100 na siya, so equal siya sa 0.005, no? So 0.005 or 5 milli ang iyang relative error, no? So pag-abot sa kan 5 milli per meter na siya na consideration, no? So pag-abot sa kan instrument B, 0.25 divide nato sa 10 meter equal lang siya sa 0.025. So 0.025 or 25 millimeter per meter. No, so that's the relative error. So it means na mas dako ang relative error ni instrument B compare kan instrument A. So 0.05 compare ni mo siya sa 5 milli per meter compare sa 25 milli per meter, mas dako yung error ang instrument B, relative error. So it means na mas accurate si instrument A. So sa ingana na case, mas useful si relative error, no? So mo na siya importante na may bala na to ang difference ni absolute error and relative error kay na siya specific nga use. Okay, so how about the percentage error? So si percentage error is almost the same lang ni siya kan relative error. The difference is instead of using decimal values, we will be using percentage, no? So that's why ang relative error multiply lang nato na siya og 100%. Okay, so for example, you have this 7.5846712, which is our true error, and then 7.585, which is our approximation. So ato lang na siya i-subtract, then i-divide din siya sa true value, which is 7.5846712. Then i-multiply lang dayon siya sa 100. So whatever the result ana niya, no, so wala lang ni siya naabot ang, no. So ang answer jud ani is 0.4% ni siya ang answer ani. No, so kani siya is naka decimal pa man ni siya. Ay, sorry, 0.004%, wala lang nabutang ang percent ni siya ang n, no. So kana siya. So bali relative error times the 100%, muna na siya ang percentage error or EP. And then we also have the general formula for error. So let Q be equal to FXYZ be the function of three variables. So we have delta u equals to partial derivatives of f with respect to x times delta x plus partial derivatives of f with respect to y delta y plus partial derivatives of f with respect to z delta z. Then let u be equal to function of x x1 x sub 2 up to x sub n be the function of n variable. So bali in general moni siya kung halimbawa 3 variables lang moni siya ang delta u, no? So tama siya sa z, but in general kung halimbawa abot na og n variables ang atong function, abot ni tayo up to infinity pa man na siya. So moni siya ang general function, general formula sa error. So this is the delta u is the error, no? Si delta u, why is that delta u? Because this is the difference between two u's, no? So we have true u and kanang approximate na u, no, which is equal na siya sa delta u. So this is the error itself, no? In general mo na siyang yung formula, it is just the partial derivatives of f with respect to x multiplied by delta. Bali, summation lang siya sa partial derivatives multiplied by the difference of the variables, no? Or delta, deltas of the variables, no? So, kung isamap na nimo na siya, muna na siya ang total error, bali nimo, no? So, to solve for relative error, ER, you will just divide the delta U over U. Pod. Bali, kung naki delta U, which is the the true error, no? I-divide niyo muna siya sa true value ni u, so you will have the relative error. Okay? Ano siya? So, here's an example. Find the relative maximum error in the function mu is equal to 5xy squared over z cubed at x is equal to y is equal to z equals to 1 with delta x is equal to delta y equals to delta z equal to 0.001. So the solution will be u is equal to 5xy squared over z will be delta a partial derivative of u with respect to x, so which is equal to 5y squared over z cubed. Then partial derivative of u with respect to y is equal to 10xy over z cubed. Then partial derivative of u with respect to z is equal to negative 15x squared xy squared over z fourth, z to the fourth. And then it is ang iyang approximate value is that x is equal to y is equal to z is equal to 1. So bali 1 sila tamat tanan, no? So it means ng u na to is equal to 5 approximately, no? And true u na to is equal to 5, no? So when you substitute x, y, and z as 1, so we have 5 times 1 times 1 squared over 1 cubed, so 1 rani sila tanan. So 1 times 1 times 1 times 5, so 5 ang iyong answer, no? So it means na u is equal to 5, no? So and then to solve for the u max, sorry, to solve for u max, maximum delta of u, we have absolute value of 5y squared over z cubed times delta x plus 10xy over z cubed times delta y plus absolute value of negative 15xy squared over times delta z over absolute value of z to the fourth. And then, ito lang substitute ng mga value, no? So, kani siya, 1, 1 naman eh, kaning 1, kaning y of z, so this will become 5 delta x, no? And then, we all know that delta x is equal to 0.001. So, that's why it will become 5 times 0.001. And then, we also have 10 times, kini sila, mga 1 naman sila tanan, so mabili na lang is just 10 times delta y, and delta y is also 0.001, so mo na siyang 10 times 0.001 plus 15 negative 15, so absolute value ni negative 15 times xy squared, so kani siya mga 1 naman po sila ni kining XYZ, so mabili na lang is negative 15 delta Z. But absolute value man ang gipanghita, so mao nang positive 15 gyapon siya dire. No, and then we have delta Z. No, so si delta Z is equal to 0.001, so mao nang 15 times 0.001 siya. And then if we simplify for that, we have 5 times 0.001 plus 10 times 0.001 plus 15 times 0.001, which is just equal to 0.03. No? So muna siya, no, ang atong Umax or ang atong error. No, delta true error or atong general error. Okay, na delta U. So to solve for ER or relative error max, so we have delta U max over U. No, and we know that U is equal to 5, so it's just equal to 0.03, which is our delta U over 5. So which is equal to 0.006 na atong ER max. So any questions with the accuracy and error? Wala. Sige, so silence miss nan man siguro, no? So okay, so okay, so let's proceed to the last topic for this day, which is the Taylor series. Okay, ako sa ni stop share. Okay, so our last subtopic for today is the Taylor series or the polynomial is a representation of a function as an infinite sum of terms calculated from the values of its derivatives at a single point. So just like ang akong gipakita sa inyo kanina na naka-series ba itong Taylor, no? So na siya approximate nga y or function, no? Function of values, and then gi-truncate siya, no? Gi-chunk siya into different terms, no? So infinite sum of infinite terms, no? Kana siya. So mo siya ang si Taylor series. So pag ang atong gamito na ta single point or atong i-assume si x to be 0, no? So i-assume nato si x to be a 0, that is called a Maclaurin polynomial, no? So natay Taylor polynomial, which is general siya na Taylor series, which is general na siya for any values of x, no? So for Maclaurin series, atong di-assume na atong x to be 0, no? Bali atong single point is 0. Okay, it could be either, kung ano ba, multivariable na siya, it could be either x, y, or z, or x1, x2, x3, x4, x to the n, na equal siya sa 0. So that's a Maclaurin polynomial. So this is the example, no? So we of the Taylor series. So general formula judiay na siya sa Taylor series. So we have function of x, so which is equal to the summation of cn multiplied by x minus a raised to the power of n, where n starts from 0 to the infinity. Okay, so and then a is equal to the center. So center mo na siya atong i-consider na point, no? So kung halimbawa si atong i-consider na point is 0, so that's that will become a Maclaurin, no? So then cn is equal to f to the power fn prime, no? N prime ni siya, or means na kung kapila siya giderive, no? Derivatives of c, which is our constant, considered na constant na to, n factorial over n factorial. Okay? Then kung ato na siya i-simplify, ato i-substitute ang kaning f to f n prime of c over n factorial sa cn, the f of x will become summation of f n prime of c multiplied by x minus a to the power of n over n factorial starting from 0 n equal to 0 to the infinity. So, mani siya ang general formula sa Taylor series. Okay? So, here's an example. So, find the Taylor series for the function f of x is equal to ln x centered at c is equal to 1. So, it means na itong center is C1 instead of 0, which is kung 0 na siya, maklori na siya. So, f of x is equal to ln of x, f of 1 is equal to ln of 1 is equal to 0. No? So, ang atong consideration na ni is up to 4th prime siya. No? So, just like sa atong formula, we will just sum up the ln of the derivatives up to 4th degree. No? So, we have f prime of x, we have f double prime of x, we have f triple prime of x, then we have f to the 4th prime of x. No? So, for f of x sub O, which is equal to ln of x, centered siya at c is equal to 1. So, we will just substitute x be equal to 1. No? So, we have f of 1 is equal to ln of 1, which is equal to 0. And then, f prime of x is equal to 1 over x. No? And then, f prime of 1 is equal to 1 over 1 or equal to 1. No? And then f double prime of x is equal to negative 1 over x squared, or just f double prime of 1 minus f double prime of 1 equals to negative 1 over 1 squared, or simply 1. No? And then we also have f triple prime of x, which is equal to 2 over x cubed. And then f triple prime of 1 equals to 2, no? So, this is just 1, 2 over 1 cube. So, 2 over 1 lang na siya. So, just equal to 2. And then, we have f 4 prime of x equals to negative 6 times x to the 4th. No? So, kasi naman tayo saan pag-solve na siya. So, we will just take the derivatives of 2 over x cube. So, this will result into negative 6 over x fourth. So, kung ato i-substitute ang 1, this is just equal to negative 6. Okay? And then, we will just plug in the values sa atong formula. So, we have ln of x equals to 0, which is our f of c sub o, plus 1 times x minus 1 raised to the power of 1 over 1 factorial. So, for the first degree na siya. Minus 1. So, 1 is the f double prime c for the second degree, x minus 1 squared over 2 factorial, plus 2 times x minus 1 cube over 3 factorial, minus 6 times x minus 1 to the 4th over 4 factorial. So, kanan siya is just the substitution lang siya sa mga values. Okay, so that's the the value, no? So if we generalize the value, no, we can say, no, kung sa inyo ma-observe 3a, so this is 1 over 1, so 1 factorial is 1, no? So 1 over 1 na siya sa first na sa first na degree. So 1 over 1, so this is just 1 minus 1 over 2 factorial. So 2 factorial is just 2. No? Then 2 over 3. So 3 factorial is 6. No? So 2 over 6 is just 1 third. And then 6 over 4 factorial, so 4 factorial is just 24, so this will become over 6, no? I mean over 4, no? Because 24 divided by 6 is just 4, no? So, muna dyan ang resulta ni niya, no? So, ang mabili na lang is just x minus 1 over 1 minus x minus 1 squared over 2 plus x minus 1 cube over 3 minus x minus 1 fourth over 4. So, kung ito na siya i-generalize, kung ito sila i-observe, when n is equal to 1, positive, when n is odd, positive siya. No? When, no? Makita ninyo, si 1, positive. Si 3, positive. No? So, when n is equal to 1, positive siya. Balik, kung iyang, ang iyang exponent niya is 1, positive siya. So, kung halimbawa, odd pod siya, just like 2 and 4, ang iyang exponent, negative siya. No? So, muna siyang naa siya ay negative 1 multiply to the n. No? So, kung kita ay add siya, so, bali, ang n na to, diri, is just mag-start siya sa 0. No? So, bali, ang iyang exponent, makonsider siya as n plus 1. Okay? Kaya nag-start man siya sa 0. But, kalimbawa, nag-start siya sa 1, n is equal to 1. So, kani siya, probably, may mo na siya n minus 1. No? So, kana siya. Kaya, di ang makamag-start kung kano sa siya nag-negative. Diba? So, muna siya, kung asa siya nag-start man siya sa 0, so nag-start siya, nga positive siya because negative 1 to the 0 is just 1. No? So muna siya negative 1 to the n siya. And then pag-abot po diriya sa x minus 1, as you observe, so sa first, kung ang atong n is mag-start siya sa 0, sa first term niya, kung ato lang siya adan of 1, muna siyang atong first na term. No? So, just like, diriya sa first term na to, ang exponent is 1. So, which is, in the beginning, atong n is equal to 0. So, n, para ma-generalize na siya, that should be n plus 1. Because our n is equal to 0. So, 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. So, just like diriya, na case, sa kanina case, sa kanina term, ang atong n na is equal to 1. No? So, para mahimo siya to, kinanglan nato siya adan ng 1. So, mana siyang n plus 1 dira. No, same gihapon sa iyang denominator. So, in the beginning, n is equal to 0. No, then kung ato siya adan ng 1, para kung ato siya adan ng 1, mahimo na siya 1. No? And then second term pod, which is n is equal to 1 na siya, kung adan na to siya o 1, mahimo na siya 2. Sa third na to na term, which is n is equal to 2 na dira, kung adan na to siya o 1, mahimo na siya 3. No? So, you will just look for the pattern sa mga values in each term. And then, you can summarize or just simplify it into a single summation. No? So, this is the Taylor series for ln of x. So, ln of x is equal to summation of negative 1 raised to the power of n multiplied by x minus 1 n plus 1 over n plus 1. Okay? Sige. So, that's the Taylor series. So, any question with regards to Taylor series? Any question with regards to Taylor series? Hello?